To become wealthy starts with having the best mindset. Some have poor mindset that becoming rich is beyond their reach. The rich have entirely different beliefs regarding money that separates them from those who never succeed with their finances. Why is the rich seems to grow richer over time while the poor remain poor and even become poorer? Why do the rich build wealth continuously over time while the poor never experience an increase in net worth? If they receive a large amount of cash, such as tax refund, it's instantly spent on a new TV or a trip. Assuming basic requirements are accounted for, wealthy and poor people think about money in entirely different methods. So, let's find out why the rich always get richer and why the poor middle class never escape mediocrity. Hello friends, welcome to our channel. If you want to watch this kind of video, press the subscribe button and hit the bell icon. If this video seems helpful, like it and share it with others. If you have any concerns, questions or tips about the video, leave a comment down below. Currently, let's get started. The rich learn about money. Poor people remain so, since they don't want to learn about money and how they can use it to enhance their lives. They are usually intimidated by finances, afraid to fail. But nearly every person has access to financial literacy, reading material on the internet or YouTube. But some people don't bother to utilize it to their advantage. A common phrase of a poor person is, "I don't care about money." Well, money plays a large part in our lives, whether they realize it. Where you live, what you do throughout your day, what you drive, what you do for fun, where your holidays, what you eat, and a large part of your health is identified by money. Take a minute and think about what your life would look like if you had an unlimited quantity of cash. People spend way even more time thinking of money than they realize. So, finding out just how it can be used to improve your life is essential. They use debt to their advantage. Many people think about debt as a bad thing that costs you cash monthly, and debt is often misused. It's a simple way to make impulse purchases on something that you can't truly afford. A new car would be nice, and all you have to do is sign on the dotted line and drive it away today. It must go without saying that if you don't want a minimum of having the capability to pay money for a product, it's beyond your reach. Poor people see credit as a way to immediately get what they want without needing to earn money to buy it first. They think debt always costs them money. On the other hand, rich people use debt to their advantage, usually in purchasing income-creating assets that will undoubtedly make them money. For example, they could use a mortgage to buy a rental property that will certainly produce income over a long period. As opposed to making use of cash to purchase a new car, they use a low-interest loan so the money can be used to expand a business investment or create a new income stream. Rich people are smart with debts and use it to purchase items that can really afford or certainly earn them money. They make investing a priority. Poor people remain poor because they don't take the step necessary to develop wealth. Poor people make excuses and claim that they cannot become successful due to a variety of reasons. Everyone can get rich. Often, those who say they cannot are likely scared to fail or don't wish to set forth the required effort. Rich people make sacrifices and make investing a priority before spending. If they wish to purchase such a new car, they will find a way to generate earnings passively to pay for the car before buying it. Put another way, they will certainly buy or create earnings-producing properties that will undoubtedly pay for the product instead of being forced to work harder. This increase in earnings could be in stocks, real estate, or just higher income from a business. It takes a little longer to make purchases by doing this. However, having these expenses paid for with passive income is worth it in the future. Poor people buy the car and after that work harder to make the payments. In 5 or 10 years, they are no better off than they were before. The rich focus on long-term profits. Poor people often don't want to be bothered to invest. It could be months or years before a return on the money is realized, and that's just also long for them. They won't need money down the road, right? They have short-term thinking and also would rather spend their cash and also enjoy it today. Rich people plan for the long term and also know that the possibility of living to see a satisfactory return on their investment is extremely high. Nobody wants to wait years to spend cash, yet the reality that profitable investments have exponential returns is what's important. By delaying the purchase of a $40,000 car and investing that money in the future, those funds will undoubtedly have turned into a much larger sum, permitting the purchase of a $400,000 car if wanted. Like with anything in life, balance is essential. You want to have some money to spend today. However, you also want to put money away for the future and permit it to grow. Having a long-term vision permits the rich to generate profits for several years, while the poor could not care less about decades in the future. They create multiple income sources. Poor people most likely only have one income source and are unaware that they must concentrate on creating numerous sources to succeed. They probably make active income from their job and nowhere else. If they require to take a sick day or determine to go on a trip, the money stops coming in completely. School always taught you to get an excellent job that will certainly pay the bills. Yet, they never suggested creating numerous streams that will certainly pay you many methods. Most rich people have multiple income sources and cash is available in various ways, whether they are actively working or taking a couple of weeks off. Even if one earning source reduces, it doesn't faze them because they know that the possibility of this happening is high. Just how do they earn money in ways beside from their job? These additional earnings resources might include income from the secondary business that they run, royalties from a book, music, or podcast rental earnings from real estate, interest from a bank account, or stock dividends. The rich search for opportunities. Rich people are constantly on the lookout for one more way to make more money, and also they know that a chance might arise anytime, so they are always prepared to jump. When there is a stock market crash, the rich recognize the opportunity and usually make huge profits by purchasing stocks at a deep discount. They are prepared for these indices by having capital ready to deploy. This is quite the opposite of the poor middle class. Middle class people get scared away from opportunities such as this and sell their stocks to the rich at an incredibly low price, assuming they even own stock. Usually, people over-leverage their homes by borrowing the maximum amounts that they can. After that, when there is an interruption to their single income source, they are forced to give it back to the financial institution who will ultimately sell it to a wealthy investor looking for opportunity. These are clear examples of direct transfer of wealth from the poor to the rich that are a result of financial inadequacy. The rich know an opportunity when they see one as well as are ready to seize it. They are committed to success. The poor and middle class are contained where they are, at least to the point that they are willing to do whatever it takes to improve their situation. They are wasting time watching TV and spending countless of hours on social media, while the rich are working extra hours learning and improving. Sure, they would undoubtedly love to be rich also. It looks impressive from the outside looking in. However, when they realize how much time and effort is involved to succeed, they decide it's not worth it. Rich people are committed to succeeding as well, as they will do nearly whatever it takes. Even if they fail, they will keep trying because they know that anybody who has achieved massive success has likely failed several times. Rich people understand the value of money and exactly how it can be exchanged and exactly how it can be enhanced lives. So, they try so difficultly to achieve it. Being poor is challenging as well as becoming rich is hard as well. So, take your pick. Which would you rather be? You could struggle to pay bills, living paycheck to paycheck, hoping you don't get kicked out of your home, or you might worry about things that the rich brother with, like if their financial investment multiplies by 100. So, they can reach a new level of financial security. Keep in mind the things that rich people do so you as well can achieve success. Following their footsteps will ensure you get richer over time while others continue their current trajectory of expanding poorer. And that's all I want to show you in this video. If you guys got some value out of this video, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends and family. If you want more videos, subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon. Don't forget to let us know whether your concept is clear from this video in the comments below. Thanks for watching and I will see you in the next one.